Hello and welcome to Protein Factory's news video. Today we will look at the hydrodynamic and more specifically at the reverse hydrodynamic effect. In 1883, Sir Tower was experimenting with a bearing bush from a railway freight wagon. At these times, the railway carriage has been replaced by a radial load pointing vertically towards the ground, which was applied to the axle via a vertical bush. Triggered by spinning, the axle almost halfway plunged into an oil-filled gasket, supplied lubricating to the bearings. Tower requested to tamp a radial bore previously machined into the bush housing. To his surprise, after a few rotations of the axle, the cork popped off slowly. After having replaced the cork with a wooden pin, the same effect occurred again. Then he ordered to mount a pressure gauge into the separate hole, which hit the 102 psi mark. To illustrate this effect, Protogene has recreated a small model of this experiment in order to show you that under a specific load, a spinning axle will recreate raising pressure and act as a hydraulic pump. Indeed, the flow rate isn't very high, it is still impressive depending on the available area collecting the fluids. During our test sequences, we start with values of approximately 18 psi and stop at 18 psi. Higher pressure can be reached by tightening up the screw for radial loads.